Assalamualaikum dan salam sejahtera. Hi guys, see you again in new chapter, which is chapter 3, Electrochemistry. And now, we are going to focus in 3.1 subtopic, galvanic cell. So guys, let's start. Okay guys, before we look at the subtopic 3.1, I want to let you know that chapter 3, we have 3 subtopic. First, we have 3.1 galvanic cell, 3.2 Nernst equation, and 3.3 we focus on electrolytic cell. And now, we are going to look at 3.1 first, which is galvanic cell. Okay guys, what is electrochemistry? So you need to know that electrochemistry is the study of relationship between chemical change and electrical work. So daripada chemical energy, it will convert to electrical energy. So electrochemical cell consists of two types. The first one, we have voltage cell, also known as galvanic cell. So this is the diagram of voltage cell. So after this, we are going to learn further about galvanic cell. And the second one, we have electrolytic cell. So this electrolytic cell, we are going to learn it in subtopic 3.3 later. Okay, before we look at the process of galvanic cell, what you need to know that all the electrochemical cell must involve this reaction, which is redox reaction. What is mean by redox? Redox means by oxidation and reduction. So in electrochemical cell, it must occur both process here, which is oxidation process and reduction process occur at the same time. Okay, for example here, you have this overall equation for one reaction. Zinc solid react with 2 hydrogen aqueous positive charge ion, produce zinc 2 plus ion in aqueous phase, react plus hydrogen gas. So this process, you boleh dapat tahu dekat sini adanya berlaku reduction reaction and oxidation reaction. Okay, for example here, if we separate this equation, zinc to zinc 2 plus. So if you look at this half cell equation, from zinc solid change to zinc 2 plus, we know that the oxidation number increase from 0 to positive 2. So means in zinc, oxidation reaction will occur. See? So from oxidation number, you boleh tahu whether this reaction occur oxidation or reduction. Alright? And then for hydrogen, from positive 2, so kalau kita balance equation, dia ada darab 2 kat sini kan? So become 0. So we need to know that here, for hydrogen, it will occur reduction reaction because the oxidation number decreased from positive 2 to 0. So this is the explanation about redox reaction. Okay, so if you look at this explanation, you boleh faham lebih lagi lah. Alright, so now look here. For oxidation, one reactant will lose the electron and it will become reducing agent. So kalau dia berlaku oxidation, dia akan bertindak sebagai reducing agent and oxidation number will increase. So tolong faham statement tu. Okay, so here for zinc, we know that zinc will lose electron. Kan? Zinc is the reducing agent and become oxidized. So bila zinc undergo oxidation, so zinc akan bertindak sebagai reducing agent. So dia akan vice versa ya guys. So the oxidation number of zinc will increase from 0 to positive 2. So like seperti yang saya explain tadi, okay? And then for reduction process, as we know that the reactant will gain electron. So it will act as oxidizing agent. So as we know that oxidizing agent akan berlaku reduction pada diri dia. Okay, so oxidation number will decrease. So ingat, remember. So kalau dia berlaku reduction, so dia akan bertindak sebagai oxidizing agent. So here, hydrogen ion will gain electron. So hydrogen ion is the oxidizing agent and becomes reduced. So here, H plus ni adalah oxidizing agent, while zinc solid ni adalah reducing agent. Okay, so the oxidation number of hydrogen decrease from positive 1 to 0. Seperti yang saya tunjuk tadi, saya tunjuk positive 2 sebab saya detect daripada balancing equation. Tapi kalau daripada half cell equation, H plus ni cuma positive 1 je. Tapi sebenarnya kalau kita relate dengan balance equation, dia sepatutnya adalah positive 2. Okay, so yang penting, it will undergo reduction for hydrogen. Okay guys, in electrochemical cell, we need electrodes. Okay, we need electrode untuk dia bentuk electrical energy, untuk dia immerse dalam electrolyte, which is the solution. So this is our electrode. So kalau you boleh lihat dalam gambar ni, ini adalah diagram of galvanic cell. So we have two electrode here. Okay, so we have two type of electrode actually. So after this I will explain to you. So what is electrode? So electrode is object that conduct electricity between cell and surrounding. From electrolyte, from the solution, so dia akan conduct electricity. So we have two electrode here, anode and cathode are deep into an electrolyte. Seperti yang saya jelaskan tadi. So kita ada anode, kita ada cathode. Okay, normally at anode it will undergo oxidation process, while at cathode will undergo reduction process. So itu adalah basic knowledge in electrochemical cell. So here we have two type of electrode. First, we have active electrode. Active electrode will involve in half cell reaction. So this is the example of active electrode. We have zinc electrode, copper electrode, iron electrode. So all these electrode will involve in your equation, okay? In your reaction. So maksudnya bila you buat half cell equation nanti, dia akan ada di situ. Alright? Inactive electrode do not involve in the reaction. Okay, like carbon electrode atau graphite electrode, and we have platinum electrode. So both electrode here will not involve in your reaction. So when you write the equation, the half cell equation or the overall equation, inactive electrode tidak akan terlibat di dalam equation. So you need to know about this type of electrode. Alright, so just now we already look at the type of electrode. So jika nak buat electrochemical cell, kita juga mesti kena ada electrolyte. Electrolyte tu adalah solution yang kita dipkan our electrode just now. Okay, we have two type of electrolyte. The first one, if you use pure compound, okay, which is the molten salt, molten dalam keadaan leburan without mixed with H2O. Okay, or we use aqueous solution of salt, for example, like sodium chloride solution, sodium sulfate solution. So this is the example of electrolyte that you can use in electrochemical cell. Okay guys, now we look at voltaic cell or galvanic cell. So in this chapter, we are going to focus only on galvanic cell sahaja. Okay? So apa itu voltaic cell? So voltaic cell use a spontaneous reaction to generate electrical energy. So tindak balas dia berlaku secara spontan. Dia tidak menggunakan apa-apa bateri ataupun tidak menggunakan apa-apa power supply. So you kena faham apa itu galvanic cell. Galvanic cell ni canggih sebenarnya. Okay? So all batteries contain voltaic cell. So bateri yang kita guna hari-hari tu semua mengandungi voltaic cell. Okay? Sebab bateri tu menukarkan chemical energy to electrical energy. That is galvanic cell. Canggih kan, daripada chemical dia tukar kepada electrical. So dia tidak memerlukan apa-apa power supply. Okay? So this is the example of galvanic cell or voltaic cell. So you need to know how to draw the galvanic cell here. So this is how you draw the galvanic cell. Okay? So ini 2D version. 2D version diagram. So ini cara kalau dalam exam awak lukis. Okay? So bila awak lukis, awak kena ada dua beaker dekat sini. Alright? So satu solution untuk anode dan satu solution untuk cathode. So kita akan guna two different solution that consists of here. If you look, we have zinc electrode in aqueous solution of zinc. So dia mesti menggunakan solution dan electrode yang sama dengan solution. Okay. Kemudian kita ada here copper electrode in an aqueous solution of copper 2+. So we have copper sulfate here. And then the two electrode are connect by a wire. So they connect by a wire. Kita sambungkan pada voltmeter. So voltmeter ni lah peranan dia untuk detect electrical energy. Kita dapat lihat ada arus elektrik yang mengalir. And then the two container here, the beaker here, will connected by a salt bridge. What is the function of salt bridge here? Later I will explain to you. Okay? And then a voltmeter, tadi saya dah kata, is used to detect voltage generate. Okay? So this is how you draw the voltaic cell atau galvanic cell. Okay? Make sure bila dalam exam, bila you lukis, make sure you label kan. Okay, for galvanic cell, anode electrode akan jadi sebagai negative electrode. While cathode electrode akan bertindak sebagai positive electrode. Okay, so how galvanic cell function? Macam mana galvanic cell ni berfungsi, kelas? Okay, what happened at the anode electrode and what happened to the cathode electrode? Okay, let me explain to you. Okay, we focus on the anode electrode first. Okay, we know that anode electrode, we have zinc electrode here. So what happened at zinc electrode? Zinc metal here will immerse in zinc 2+ electrolyte, which is here we have solution of zinc sulfate. And then zinc is more electropositive than copper. Macam mana saya tahu? Kalau you masih ingat, ingat tak lagi masa sekolah you all pernah belajar siri elektrokimia? So zinc ni duduk lagi atas daripada copper. Sebab tu dia lebih more electropositif. Tapi dekat matrik kita tak pakai siri elektrokimia. Kita akan guna standard reduction potential table. Later I will show you. Okay? So zinc has more tendency to release electron, means zinc will undergo oxidation. So zinc is the negative electron since it is a source of electron. So anode ni akan mula untuk donate electron kepada cathode. So what is the observation at anode electrode? So biasa kalau dalam exam dia suka tanya apa observation yang berlaku pada anode. So macam mana you nak tulis? So this is how you write the observation. So observation at anode: zinc metal dissolve and the mass of zinc electrode will decrease. It means that zinc electron akan berlakunya corrosion. Terkakis kelas. Kalau you pernah dengar masa sekolah kan. So zinc electron will corrode and so the mass of zinc electron will decrease. So here at anode will occur oxidation process. So zinc to plus ion will enter the zinc sulfate solution. So dalam ni akan banyak zinc to plus ion sebab zinc solid electrode undergo oxidation. So that is itu yang berlaku pada anode electrode. Okay, pada ke sebelah anode. Next we look at cathode part. Okay, so what happened at the copper electrode, guys? So as we know that copper metal here will immerse in Cu2 plus electrolyte, which is copper sulfate solution here, and the electron from zinc metal move out through the wire and enter the copper metal. It means that copper here will accept the electron. So copper here will undergo reduction. So copper 2 plus akan accept 2 electron, become copper solid. So copper is the positive electron. So seperti yang saya dah explain tadi, so dia jadi cathode. So what happened at the copper electrode? So what is the observation at cathode? So apa yang berlaku? So kita tahu tadi dia undergo reduction. Okay. So the observation is, so copper will deposited at the copper electrode. Deposited maksudnya dia akan termendak, kan? And the mass of copper electrode will increase. Okay, sebab berlakunya deposited kat sini. So dia akan ada mendakan pada copper electrode tersebut. Macam mana? So macam ni lah. Dia akan ada mendakan dekat situ. Nampak? Okay, so copper electrode, the mass dia akan increase. Okay, so I'll show you the half equation. So tadi kita tahu Cu2 plus aqueous, dia akan accept electron from zinc, become Cu solid. Sebab tu dekat copper electrode ada deposited. Ada copper metal yang deposited. So look at the half equation. So kalau tadi dekat zinc, from zinc solid dia akan donate electron, become zinc 2 plus aqueous plus 2 electron. So sebab tu dekat anode zinc akan terkakis. The zinc metal will dissolve. So from solid dia change to zinc 2 plus aqueous. So this is the process of galvanic cell. Okay guys, now we look at the function of salt bridge. So this is the example of salt bridge that we use in our lab. So kalau sempat you all buat eksperimen nanti, you boleh tengok lah salt bridge. Tapi masa sekolah, okay, masa you all sekolah dulu, masa saya sekolah dulu, kita guna filter paper kan, kertas turas. Okay, sebagai awak punya salt bridge, di mana kertas turas tu awak rendamkan dalam satu larutan dan you akan connectkan antara dua bekas tu kan, dua beaker tu. Okay, so dalam salt bridge ni biasanya, okay, ini yang modern ya kelas. Okay, so dalam salt bridge ni will contain a solution of non-reacting ion such as potassium chloride, potassium nitrate, sodium sulfate, so which act as a liquid wire. So salt bridge ni dia akan bertindak sebagai liquid wire, allowing ion to flow and complete the circuit. So actually what is the function of salt bridge? So this is the function of salt bridge class. Salt bridge will maintain the electrical neutrality of the cell. Okay, how? So let me explain to you. So look at this diagram. So this is how the cell maintain its electrical neutrality. Okay, just now we know that at anode, okay, dekat anode, zinc will undergo oxidation. So it will release zinc 2 plus, dia akan release electron, then it will form zinc 2 plus ion. So Zg2 plus ion will enter the solution causing the overall excess of positive charge. So macam mana tu? Apabila zinc solid berubah menjadi Zg2 plus, dia menyebabkan dalam solution zinc sulfate mengandungi lebih banyak positif ion dalam tu. So lagi bila lagi banyak positif ion yang ada dalam zinc sulfate ni, so dia dah tak balance class. Positive charge dengan negative charge yang ada dalam zinc sulfate ni dah tak balance. So what happen, macam mana dia nak bagi balance positive charge and negative charge? So Cl- ion in the salt bridge will move into zinc half cell. So dalam salt bridge ni, contoh kalau kita ada KCl, okay? Kalau kita ada KCl, so dalam KCl tu akan ada ion positif dengan Cl minus. Okay, contoh saya tunjuk kat sini. Kalau contoh dalam salt bridge ni kita ada KCl solution, so dalam ni akan ada K plus dengan Cl minus ion. So tadi kita tahu dalam solution ni akan ada banyak Zg2 plus, so akan ada banyak positif charge. So bila positive charge increase, so negative charge dia akan rendah. So macam mana nak balancekan negative charge ion? So that's why Cl minus yang ada dalam tengok dekat sini, Cl minus ni akan move, dia akan turun ya, dia bukan keluar tau, dia akan turun dekat sini. So dia akan berada dekat dalam, still dalam salt bridge punya alat radas tu. Okay, dia cuma dia akan turun, dia akan balancekan negative charge yang ada dalam anode solution. Okay, nampak? And then at cathode pula, we know that cathode will undergo reduction. So Cu2 plus will accept the electron from zinc tadi. So dia akan jadi Cu solid. So Cu2 plus leave the solution causing the overall excess of negative charge. So bila Cu2 plus ni berubah menjadi Cu solid, so kandungan positive charge dalam ni akan berkurang. Negative charge akan bertambah kelas. So bila negative charge bertambah, so dalam solution dekat cathode dia tak neutral dah. So macam mana nak maintain electrical neutrality dalam bekas cathode? So K plus, so K plus ion akan turun bawah. So dia akan turun kat dalam ni. Okay, bukan turun dalam solution dia, dia turun dekat salur salt bridge tu. Okay, so dia akan turun dekat bawah tu. So dia akan maintain neutrality of cathode solution. Okay, so positive ion dengan negative ion yang ada dalam cathode solution tu akan balance semula. So that's why electrical neutrality is maintained in both solution. Understand guys? So this is the function of salt bridge. Okay, next we look how to write the cell notation. Saya nak ajar you all how to write the cell notation. Before this in school, you tak pernah belajar lagi cell notation ni. Okay, so actually the cell notation ni dia melambangkan galvanic cell itu sendiri without diagram. So how to write the cell notation? Okay, so tadi kita dah ada reaction between zinc and copper. So this is the overall equation. Okay, just now I already write to you the half cell equation at anode and half cell equation at cathode. So you dah tahu equation yang berada pada anode dan cathode. So now here saya dah combinekan dia membentuk satu overall equation. So how to write the cell notation? So you kena tahu ya, sebab kadang-kadang soalan tak beri you all diagram. Dia akan beri you all macam ni. Okay, dia akan beri you all macam ni. So, inilah cell notation guys. So, apa itu? Macam mana nak baca? Senang cerita. So, sebenarnya cell notation ni dia melambangkan galvanic cell you all dalam bentuk equation. Okay, So this is overall equation. So from overall equation ni, you boleh tulis cell notation. So left side ni, yang ni, ini untuk anode side. Okay, while the right side here adalah untuk cathode side. Okay, so yang tengah-tengah ni apa? Okay. So yang double line ni, okay, this one represent salt bridge. Okay. So anode should be on the left side, cathode should be on the right side. So the one line here, the single line here represent the phase boundary. Phase boundary ni macam mana? Phase boundary ni dia memisahkan antara electrode dengan electrolyte. For example here saya dah label kan. Okay, zinc solid dekat sini kita tahu dia akan jadi anode electrode, yang immerse dalam electrolyte tadi kan. Okay, kemudian kita ada solution zinc, so zinc 2+, kat sini dalam ni ada zinc 2+ aqueous. So kat sini concentration dia pun kena tulis. Kalau dia pada standard condition 25 degree Celsius, the concentration of the solution should be 1 molar. Kena tulis ya. Untuk aqueous phase kena tulis dia punya concentration. So this is our anode electrolyte. So anode electrolyte akan dipisahkan dengan cathode electrolyte by using salt bridge. Okay, tadi awak dah dapat imagine based on the diagram, right? Okay, and then cathode electrolyte dengan cathode electrode kita pisahkan melalui single line here. So this is your cathode electrode and this is your cathode electrolyte. So Cu2+ aqueous and the concentration is 1 molar this reaction at standard condition. Okay, boleh faham? So senang cerita, yang hujung-hujung kiri dan kanan ni mesti ditutup oleh electrode. Okay, katakanlah kita guna electrode, inert electrode macam mana? Kejap lagi kita tengok contoh lain. Okay, so we look at the other version of example for cell notation. Okay, for example here, kita ada overall equation. Silver solid react with chlorine gas produce silver ion aqueous plus Cl minus aqueous. Okay, so if you look at this overall equation, we already know that silver will undergo oxidation, right? Because silver here, from silver solid become silver ion positive charge. So this oxidation number increase. So silver akan undergo oxidation. So silver will be your anode. While chlorine will undergo reduction from Cl2 gas, the zero oxidation number here become Cl minus aqueous. So it means that here it will undergo reduction. So your chlorine should be cathode side. Okay, so how to write the cell notation? Sebab silver dia ada solid. So dia bolehlah jadi electrode. Tapi chlorine tak ada solid, guys. So apa dia punya electrode? So dekat sinilah inert electrode akan main peranan. Okay, so here look at the cell notation. So for silver saya rasa okay sebab kita ada silver solid. So silver solid here akan jadi anode electrode. While the silver ion here aqueous 1 molar here should be our anode electrolyte. So separate by salt bridge. So here look, dekat chlorine ada 3 bahagian. Okay, so dekat sini chlorine dia ada gaseous phase dengan aqueous phase. So guys, untuk memisahkan phase antara solid, liquid, gas, aqueous, kita kena guna single line ni. Tadi saya dah cakap single line ni is used to separate ataupun to represent phase boundary. Okay, so here kita ada gas dengan aqueous, so kita akan guna single line. So Cl2 gas, okay, bila standard condition dia mesti pada 1 atm. and then untuk aqueous 1 molar. So as we know that dalam overall equation ni tidak ditunjukkan pun apa-apa solid kan untuk bahagian cathode. It means that for cathode side, untuk bahagian cathode dia akan guna inert electrode. So either dia guna platinum electrode or graphite electrode. So if you still remember just now saya ada bagi tahu platinum electrode or graphite electrode yang jadi sebagai inert electrode will not involve in the half cell equation atau dalam reaction. Sebab tu dalam overall equation ni tidak ditunjuk pun platinum itu berada di mana. But in cell notation, you need to show the inert electrode. Ah, saya dah kata, hujung kiri dan kanan mesti diapit oleh electrode. So, bermaksud kalau dalam equation tidak ada solid part untuk anode or cathode, bermaksud it will use inert electrode. So, you can choose either graphite or platinum. Okay, so this is the other version of cell notation. What happened in the overall equation, you have same phase for the one half cell equation. Okay, contoh untuk anode, saya rasa tak ada masalah. Okay, untuk cathode, cuba awak tengok. Untuk cathode, dalam overall equation, dia punya part semua aqueous. Kalau dalam ni tadi, kita ada gas dengan aqueous. Tapi macam mana kalau berlakunya left side and right side for cathode adalah aqueous. So untuk same phase, aqueous, kita akan guna comma. Okay, component that are in the same phase. So ingat, single line here we use untuk memisahkan antara different phase, gas, solid, liquid. But if same phase, we use comma. Okay? Boleh faham? And one more thing guys, saya nak inform dekat sini, balancing equation tidak akan ditunjuk dalam cell notation. So, dua ni tidak perlu ditulis dekat sini. Tak perlu. Okay? Tak boleh tulis balancing equation. Yang kita masukkan dalam cell notation adalah dia punya compound ion ataupun elemen sahaja. So balancing equation 2, 3 mol coefficient tu tidak perlu dimasukkan di dalam cell notation. Okay, tolong faham. Okay guys, so now we look at standard cell potential. Okay, actually we have two type of cell potential. First, cell potential adalah dia punya simbol E cell, kan? Okay. So E cell ni adalah different in electrical potential of electrode. Maksudnya between cathode dengan anode, also called as voltage or electromotive force, EMF. Okay. So the unit of cell potential normally adalah volt. Right? So, cell potential reaction ni, kalau nanti bila awak kira, nanti kita akan tengok lebih lanjut dalam subtopik 3.2. So, if value of cell potential more than 0 means the cell reaction is spontaneous. If the value of cell potential you got less than 0, maksudnya negative something, so that reaction will occur non-spontaneously. While if the reaction, the cell potential equal to 0, it means that the reaction already reached equilibrium. So ni benda penting ya. So later, you akan belajar lebih lanjut dalam subtopik 3.2. Okay, so kita juga ada standard cell potential. Apa beza antara cell potential and standard cell potential? So, look at the symbol here. Bila ada perkataan standard, bermaksud dia akan ada simbol ni, note ni kan, E note cell. So, E note cell ni adalah different in electrical potential of electrode measured at a specific temperature. Normally at standard condition, which is 25 degrees Celsius or 298 Kelvin, with all the component in their standard state. Saya pernah explain pasal standard state ni dalam chapter 2. Apa itu standard state? Ulang lagi sekali lah. Okay, 1 atm pressure for gases, 1 molar concentration for the solution and pure solid for the electrode. Yang ni saya dah bagi tahu tadi kan. Sebab tu kalau awak tengok dalam cell notation tadi, ada solution yang aqueous, solution yang kita punya phase aqueous tadi, concentration dia adalah 1 molar. Means that reaction will occur at standard state. So guys, how to calculate standard cell potential? So standard cell potential, you boleh kira menggunakan formula ni, iaitu E not cell equal to E not cathode minus E not anode. So tolong stick pada satu sahaja formula ini, sebab kalau ikutkan dalam lecture note you, ada lagi satu formula. Tapi saya tak nak guna formula tu, sebab formula tu akan menyebabkan confusing pada you all. Kekeliruan pada you all. So tolong stick pada formula ini sahaja. Okay, so this is standard reduction potential table, guys. So before this, in school, you are very familiar with siri electrochemia, kan? You all kan ada hafal dulu kan? Siap buat mnemonic lagi kan? Betul? Okay, untuk matriculation, we are going to use the standard reduction potential table. So, tolong biasakan dengan diri awak dengan table ni. Okay? So, but guys, in exam, table ni tidak akan diberi ya. Oh my god, nak kena hafal ke? No, don't worry. In exam, okay, dalam soalan nanti, dia akan beri you all standard value cell potential for each half cell. So nilai-nilai ni semua akan diberi dalam exam. But half cell equation ni tak ada ya kelas. Half cell equation tidak akan diberi dalam exam. Okay, so ini adalah dia punya reference. Kita ada untuk hydrogen, dia punya E not value adalah 0. Ini nanti saya akan explain lebih lanjut dalam standard hydrogen electrode. Okay, so dekat standard reduction potential table ni, semuanya adalah at 25 degree Celsius, the pressure 1 atm for gases and the concentration of electrolyte is 1 molar. Dah nama pun standard kan? So dia mesti berlaku dekat standard state. So, changing the stoichiometric coefficient of a half cell reaction does not change the value of E naught. Dia bukan thermochemistry ya guys. Nanti ada pelajar yang dah mula confused dengan thermochemistry. Kenapa saya kata confused? Macam ni guys. Contoh kita ambil untuk magnesium. Saya ambil untuk aluminium kat sini. Okay. Contoh, kata kalau you ada kat situ Al3+, aqueous plus 3 electron produce Al solid. Kemudian nilai E-note dia adalah -1.66 volt. Okay. Maksud statement yang kedua tu, kata kalau nanti dalam equation, awak balance kan, katakanlah ke aluminium ni ada 2, dekat sini ada 2. So 2 ni memanglah dalam equation you kena darab 2, tapi nilai E not value ni no need to times 2, tak perlu. Okay guys, tak boleh darab 2. Ini bukan thermochemical equation. So, kalau dalam equation ada darab 2 ke, darab 3 ke, bahagi 2 ke, so E not value masih kekal sama. Tak perlu darab 2, tak perlu bahagi 2, tak perlu reverse pun. Kalau equation reverse pun tak payah ubah. Okay, saya bagi tahu kat sini, kalau equation awak, awak reverse equation pun E not value masih kekal sama. Jangan ubah apa-apa. Okay? Sebab apa? Sebab tu saya kata stick pada equation atau formula yang satu tadi. E not cell equal to E not cathode minus E not anode. So kalau kita guna formula tu, kita tak perlu ubah apa-apa pada E not value yang asal. Maksudnya ingot value aluminium tadi negative 1.66 volt, you tak perlu ubah apa-apa walaupun you ada darab ke, you ada reverse equation ke, no need to change anything. Fahamkan tu? Okay, so this is not thermochemical equation. Sebab kadang-kadang pelajar confuse dengan chapter 2. Okay, so nak tentukan anode cathode guys, cara dia macam ni. More positive the anode value, higher tendency for reduction. Okay, so makin nilai dia makin more positive, dia lebih cenderung undergo reduction, dan dia juga more tendency to become a cathode. Okay, so dia cenderung untuk jadi cathode. Itu cara awak tengok. Okay, macam mana you nak pilih anode atau cathode. More negative the anode value, higher tendency for oxidation reaction occur. So that element or that one akan jadi sebagai anode. Nampak eh? Kalau nilai dia more positive, dia akan jadi cathode. Kalau nilai dia more negative, dia akan jadi anode. Tolong faham. Okay, sebab kita akan apply dalam calculation later. Okay guys, now we are going to look at standard hydrogen electrode, SHE. Selalu pelajar suka sebut SHE kan? Okay, so apa function standard hydrogen electrode? Okay, before this guys, we already look at the standard reduction potential table. So you boleh tengok dalam table tu, we have a lot of value anode cell. So guys, how to measure the ability of half cell of that metal? Macam mana nak dapatkan nilai anode value tu? Standard cell potential tu. Macam mana kita nak dapatkan nilai tu untuk setiap element? Okay, so actually class, the magnitude of electrode potential tu, anode tu, depends on the tendency of metal or non-metal to lose electron or accept electron. Tapi guys, it is impossible to measure the absolute value of electrode potential directly. That's why guys, we use standard hydrogen electrode, SHE, as a standard reference to measure the electrode potential of other half cell. So sebab kita tahu hydrogen electrode tadi dia punya electrode potential adalah zero. So kita boleh guna SHE ni untuk dapatkan electrode potential untuk komponen atau metal yang lain atau non-metal yang lain. Macam mana? Macam ni. Okay, so ini cara dia. Cara dia, kita akan guna special prepared platinum electrode immersed in a 1 molar aqueous solution of strong acid. You can use HCl, okay, apa-apa strong acid, through which hydrogen gas at 1 atm is bubble. Ini contoh dalam gambar ni kelas. Ini adalah SHE, standard hydrogen electrode. Nampak tak dia punya apa orang kata, diagram dia berbeza dengan biasa. Kalau yang biasa, kita ada metal immersed in solution in the beaker and then connect with the salt bridge kan. Tapi yang ini dia ada beza sikit, sebab hydrogen electrode ni dia ada membebaskan gas. Sebab tu dia punya diagram agak berbeza dekat sini. So dalam beaker ni kita ada hydrochloric acid solution, strong acid tadi. Kemudian kita juga ada electrode. Kat sini kita guna inert electrode which is platinum. And then kita ada macam boiling tube dekat sini. Dia akan mengeluarkan gas dekat sini nanti. Okay, hydrogen gas akan release dekat sini nanti. So, ini adalah cara awak lukis hydrogen electrode, standard hydrogen electrode Okay, dalam nota dia ada tunjuk dalam bentuk 2D version. Yang saya tunjuk ni 3D version. So awak kena tahu lukis ya, standard hydrogen electrode ni, sebab pernah keluar dalam exam. Dia minta lukis standard hydrogen electrode punya diagram in 2D version. So you boleh refer your lecture note macam mana nak lukis dalam bentuk 2D version. Okay. So, dia guna, so dekat sini, ni adalah standard hydrogen electrode kita. Kemudian, ini adalah zinc electrode kita. So, dengan menggunakan SHE ni, awak boleh dapatkan nilai electrode potential bagi zinc. So, sebab apa? Sebab kita tahu SHE nilai dia adalah 0.00. Okay? So, as we know that, so bila you connect macam ni, dekat SHE ni, so apa yang you dapati bila awak kira, dan awak akan dapat nilai electrode potential bagi zinc. So dapatlah dekat sini -0.76 volt. So yang ini memang you kena try and error, nak letak mana satu anode, mana satu cathode, dekat mana satu positive electrode, negative electrode. Sebab kalau you salah letak, voltmeter ni tak boleh baca. Nampak tak? So sebab ni kena try and error. So voltmeter ni mengeluarkan bacaan. Dia mengeluarkan bacaan positive 0.76 volt. So dah boleh kira lah. So positive 0.76 volt ni adalah datang daripada voltmeter. So kita tahu katod tadi adalah SHE kosong. So boleh dapatkan nilai electrode potential bagi zinc. Tu yang dapat negatif 0.76 volt. So itu peranan SHE dekat sini. Okay, kalau you nak dapatkan elemen atau metal yang lain, contoh yang kedua saya boleh bagi kat sini, kita ada copper electrode, copper metal. Okay, so dekat sini dalam diagram ni, dia letak copper dekat cathode side while SHE dekat anode side. Baru voltmeter akan bergerak. Baru voltmeter akan memberi bacaan. Kalau you letak terbalik, voltmeter ni tak ada bacaan. Itu kena try and error macam saya cakap. So kat sini bila kita buat try and error kat sini, kita dapati hydrogen electrode ni berada pada anode dan copper berada pada cathode. Kemudian voltmeter memberi bacaan positif 0.34 volt. Positive sign tu kalau boleh letak ya kelas, wajib letak, sebab kadang-kadang dalam exam dia boleh bagi salah. So kat sini positif, kat sini letak je positif. Okay, so dekat sini akan dapat electrode potential adalah positif 0.34 volt. Okay, so dah dapat, sebab kita tahu anode punya cell potential adalah kosong. Sebab standard hydrogen electrode dia punya nilai electrode potential adalah kosong. Boleh nampak? So ini adalah function standard hydrogen electrode. Apa tadi saya kata? Standard hydrogen electrode is used as a standard reference to measure the electrode potential of other half cell. Okay guys, so this is the last part of subtopic 3.1. This one is about oxidizing and reducing agent. So macam mana nak tentukan oxidizing agent and reducing agent? Actually saya dah explain sikit masa awal-awal tadi. Kan? Okay. Contoh dekat sini. Okay, oxidizing agent biasanya berada on the left side of the half cell equation. Biasanya, okay, ini kalau half cell equation yang memang directly from standard reduction potential table. Maksudnya you belum reverse atau you belum ubah apa-apa ya. Okay, while reducing agent normally on the right side of the half cell equation. Ini kalau tidak ubah apa-apa, macam ni. Ini saya direct ambil equation ni daripada standard reduction potential table. Saya tidak ada ubah apa-apa pada equation ni. Macam mana daripada table tu saya ambil, saya letak aje. So ini adalah reduction equation both, kan? Okay. So daripada half cell equation ni, Tadi dia bagi tahu oxidizing agent berada dekat left side, dekat sini. So this is your oxidizing agent, while the reducing agent berada dekat right side, dekat bahagian produk. Okay, saya ulang, jika kita tidak ubah apa-apa equation ni daripada table tadi. Okay, so kenapa nickel 2 plus dengan iodine solid ni adalah oxidizing agent? Tolong kenal pasti kelas, sebab nanti bila awak buat equation, balancing equation, benda ni dah lari dah kelas. Okay, saya selalu cakap dengan pelajar, biasanya oxidizing agent ni dia akan mengalami reduction. Okay, tadi saya dah cakap dah masa mula-mula start slide tadi kan. Okay, oxidizing agent dia akan mengalami reduction. So kalau you boleh lihat kat sini, from nickel 2 plus dia akan hasilkan nickel solid. Daripada positive 2 become 0. So bila dia undergo reduction, dia akan bertindak sebagai oxidizing agent. Boleh nampak? Sama juga macam I2 solid ni. I2 solid become I minus. From 0 oxidation number become negative 1 oxidation number. So kat sini juga berlaku reduction process. So bila dia sendiri mengalami reduction, so dia akan bertindak sebagai oxidizing agent. Boleh nampak tak? Okay, kemudian for reducing agent dia vice versa lah kelas. So kenapa nickel solid dengan I minus aqueous ni adalah reducing agent? Okay, nickel solid ni kalau kita patah balik ke kiri, okay, katalah nickel solid produce nickel 2 plus. So nickel solid jadi nickel 2 plus. Apa yang berlaku? So dia berlaku oxidation process. So bila diri dia mengalami oxidation, so dia akan bertindak sebagai reducing agent. Nampak tak kelas? Okay, dia akan vice versa dengan proses yang dia alami. Sama juga macam I minus ni. I minus ni kalau kita patah balik ke reactant, dia akan jadi I2. Daripada negative 1 jadi 0. So means it will undergo oxidation. So that's why I minus will be your reducing agent. Boleh nampak? Okay, ada lagi satu tips yang you boleh apply. Okay, so the more negative the enode value, this one enode value, the stronger reducing agent. Okay, kalau lagi negatif, maksudnya kalau you tengok dalam table tadi lagi bawah, nilai dia lagi more negative, so kekuatan reducing agent dia lebih kuat. Okay, and then the more positive the value enode, the electrode potential just now, stronger reoxidizing agent. So lebih positif, maksudnya kalau you tengok dalam table nanti makin ke atas, so oxidizing agent dia lagi strong. Okay, so kata kalau kita guna equation ni, okay, kita jadikan sebagai one reaction. Saya tunjukkan dekat awak. Kita jadikan sebagai one reaction. So kita tahu yang ini more negative, ni more positive. Okay, nickel more negative, so nickel akan jadi anode, while iodine akan jadi cathode. Okay, ini kita jadikan dalam real reaction. Okay, so kita buat half equation dulu kelas. Okay, so anode adalah nickel tadi. So nickel anode akan undergo oxidation. Saya ulang, anode akan undergo oxidation reaction. So apa yang berlaku pada equation? Equation dia akan berubah macam ni. Dia akan jadi nickel solid produce nickel 2 plus. Betul? Sebab dia undergo oxidation. So nickel 2 plus aqueous plus 2 electron. Okay, So nilai E not value tu negative 0.25 volt tak berubah ya kelas. Nilai E not value masih kekal sama, negative 0.25 volt. Jangan ubah. Okay, ini bukan thermochemical equation. Okay, untuk cathode pula, for cathode kita tahu dia akan undergo reduction. So from I to solid, it will accept electron from anode, become 2I minus aqueous. So E not value tak berubah juga, masih positive 0.53 volt. Okay, kemudian kita nak dapatkan overall equation. So overall equation dia, kita boleh cancel out the electron. So you akan dapat nickel solid plus I2 solid produce nickel 2 plus aqueous plus 2I minus aqueous. So this is your overall equation. Okay, so now we want to identify the reducing agent and oxidizing agent. So guys, tengok dekat bahagian reactant je. Saya ulang. Tengok dekat bahagian reactant dalam overall equation. Ini cara awak detect reducing agent dengan oxidizing agent. Okey, yang pertama reactant kita ada adalah nickel solid. So nickel solid akan jadi sebagai apa guys? Sebab dia undergo oxidation, so nickel solid akan jadi reducing agent. So dalam case reaction ni, our reducing agent adalah nickel solid. Fizz pun tulis sekali ya. Okay, sebab nanti nak membezakan dengan aqueous kan. Okay, so reducing agent in our reaction now is nickel solid. Oxidizing agent, siapa? Tengok dekat reactant, I2 solid akan jadi kita punya oxidizing agent. Sebab kadang-kadang dalam soalan minta awak identify which one is reducing agent, which one is oxidizing agent. So ingat, kita akan tengok dekat reactant side in overall equation. Okay, so ini cara you identify dalam reaction sebenar. Boleh? So nanti awak boleh tengok example lebih lanjut dalam lecture note you all, macam mana you nak arrange reducing agent, oxidizing agent according to stronger to from the stronger part to the weaker part. Okay? Okay guys, finish about subtopic 3.1 galvanic cell. Later we are going to continue with subtopic 3.2 Nernst equation, still in galvanic cell calculation. Okay, bye guys, thank you.